إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, every time He legislates a ibadah for us, there are always objectives with it. There are always things that we are hoped to achieve from those acts of ibadah, those acts of worship. The most important and the most consistent of them throughout is to establish the oneness of Allah ta'ala and to worship Him alone. So anytime we pray, establishing the oneness of Allah through the takbir, through the shahada, the tashahud in salah, through reciting the Quran, glorifying Allah's name. When we're performing hajj, that's repeated constantly, the mentioning of Allah's name and the oneness of Allah. And submission to Allah and obedience to Allah. These are common objectives with every ibadah. That as an objective is itself a sufficient objective. However, alongside that, every act of worship, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also mentions to us certain fruits that we can take away and should take away from that ibadah. One of the most important, after the ones we mentioned, and it's actually part of what we've mentioned, one of the most important objectives of fasting, Allah mentions in the Quran, in the beginning of the verses of fasting and at the end of the verses of fasting, and that's taqwa. The first verse He mentions, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, O believers, kutiba alaykum as-siyam, fasting has been prescribed upon you, like it was upon those before you, kama kutiba ala alladhina min qablikum, la'allakum tattaqun, so that you may obtain taqwa. And at the end of the verses, after four or five verses, He says, كَذَلِكَ يُبَيِّنُ اللَّهُ آيَاتِهِ لِلنَّاسِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَّقُونَ. This is how Allah shows His signs, His verses to the people, so that they may obtain taqwa. So the verses of fasting begin with taqwa and end with taqwa. One of the Salaf described taqwa as being just as you would be careful in walking on a path full of thorns or full of harmful objects, or let's say lots of puddles, just as you would be careful with every step that you take to make sure that you don't damage your shoes or get water into your socks or cause yourself to be injured, the same way taqwa means to be cautious about everything we say and everything that we do. And that's really the objective of fasting, to abstain from things that are halal. Food and drink relations, are they halal or are they haram? They're all halal. But we abstain from them so that we are stronger and better and more disciplined at abstaining from the haram. That's actually haram. And this is why, if we are abstaining from these things that are normally halal, but falling into the things that are always haram, whilst fasting, the Prophet ﷺ said, فَلَيْسَ لِلَّهِ حَاجَةٌ فِي أَنْ يَدْعَ طَعَامَهُ وَشَرَابَهُ. The one who doesn't leave false speech and acting upon ignorance, then Allah doesn't need you to leave your food and drink, as reported by Imam Bukhari rahimahullah. And in another narration attributed to the Prophet ﷺ, and in its authenticity there is some debate, he said, رَبَّ صَائِمٍ لَيْسَ لَهُ مِنْ صِيَامِهِ إِلَّا جُوعٌ وَالْعَطْشِ. Perhaps someone is going to be fasting, but they take nothing away from their fast except hunger and thirst. Except hunger and thirst. And that's exactly, that's a clarification and a further addition to the previous hadith of Allah doesn't need you to leave your drink and your food. And therefore, we should use fasting not as the final objective. Okay, I didn't eat and drink, alhamdulillah, finished. But we use fasting And the month of Ramadan is a means to attain what Allah Ta'ala wanted us to attain. May Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala fill our hearts with iman and taqwa. أقول ما تسمعون واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور. الحمد لله وصلى الله وسلم على رسول الله. أما بعد يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد. Notice how the things the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned in this hadith, the one who doesn't leave these things whilst fasting, then Allah doesn't need that person to leave their food and drink. Those things all relate to our interaction with other people. He didn't mention, you know, the one that, for example, looks at haram, or the one who does something, a sin that's between you and Allah. These are of course sinful as well. But he specifically mentioned false speech and acting upon false speech and ignorance. Our interaction with other people. And hence I hope that Ramadan can be a month, brothers and sisters, in which we fix our relationships with our relatives in particular, first and foremost, and we fix our relationships with those around us generally, whether our neighbours or friends or other people. And when we manage to do that, that shows that really we've taken something away from fasting. It shows that really we've built in discipline and sabr into ourselves, which allows us to do something which maybe we might not feel like doing. Keeping on good terms, or forgiving, or having a good relationship with someone who we're upset at, or there's some sort of dispute with, or whatever it is, especially if they're relatives. If we are able to overcome those emotions, then it shows that inshallah we have perfected our fast. We'll suffice with that because of the late start. And inshallah this summary is more than sufficient, I hope, for myself and yourselves in directing ourselves in this blessed month of Ramadan. May Allah Ta'ala make it a month of blessing for all of us in our health and in our wealth and in our knowledge and in our time. May Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala fill our hearts with iman and taqwa and sabr. And may Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala alleviate anyone who is going through hardships and sufferings in this blessed month. And may it be a month in which we come closer to Allah. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن